Konnichiwa. So thanks for watching our video. I'm Satoe, teaching Reiki here in Hong Kong. So I'm from Hong Kong chapter of Japan Reiki Association. So today in this video, I'd like to do some practice distance Reiki with you. Yeah, so this is kind of a really exciting video, I believe. But today, maybe I give you some information about distance Reiki because maybe some people searching about distance Reiki on Google or on YouTube, right? So then you hit my video that, or several videos that showing that, so this is distance Reiki, but sometimes you are kind of lost, don't know what is this, or maybe you already a Reiki practitioner, you can do distance Reiki now. I think if you learn Usui Reiki, so this is level 2, if you came to the level 2, you're going to learn about distance Reiki. Yeah, so distance Reiki, there's a way, like you learn about this technique, so you really can do distance Reiki. But what is distance Reiki, by the way? Do you know the meaning of distance Reiki? Some people call distance Reiki or absent Reiki, or Japanese we call enkaku Reiki. Yeah, so we have several names about this Reiki is with distance. Yeah, so it means like some people not here, right? So you are here sitting in this room, but sometimes you think about the person, you want to send distance Reiki to somebody to help them. So that is possible by distance Reiki. Believe or not, this Usui Reiki is a practice over 100 years now, and then so this distance Reiki also has been practiced for over 100 years. So this is really an official way of practice of distance Reiki in Usui Reiki. So I hope that you also enjoyed and feel the distance Reiki in this session. So this is distance Reiki. At the beginning in Japan, it's discovered as the space difference, like for example you are here and then the somebody next door or maybe in the different place or overseas, so this is this space difference. But after Reiki spread to Western society, then it also covers the time difference as well. So this is really sounds amazing that distance Reiki actually can work beyond boundaries of time and space. Yeah, so we have so many techniques, but the simply that we can practice, so this is like a space difference, right? So some people watching my video, so then you can look at me and you can also send distance Reiki back to me, or I can also send Reiki to somebody, yeah, from here. So this is the space difference. Sometimes the people ask me like, so is this the same thing, like sending distance Reiki, sending players, so is these two same thing or not? My answer is maybe slightly no. Yeah, because Reiki is recognized as therapy. So if you receive Reiki therapy, like maybe the therapist come to you, so you receive Reiki healing face to face, then your energy is really promoted, like your energy circulating all the time. So after you receive Reiki therapy, your energy really promoted, so your energy gain or your energy more balanced. So in distance Reiki, actually the same thing will happen, that even you don't see the therapist, but your body energy circulation will be very balanced, like actually this therapy can help you more balance energy, gain energy, so that happened. So sending prayer is also the good thing, that you can also send prayers to somebody they need help. And then I also read about some documents about the power of the prayers. I think it's really true. Yeah, I heard about this. Yeah, but the prayers in sending distance Reiki, because Reiki is known as a therapy, so you're really going to receive energy. And then some people ask me like, then what kind of energy am I receiving? But this is happened because maybe you don't totally understand what is the meaning of Reiki. Yeah, so Reiki is the energy that you have, this energy actually when you are born. So this energy is a fundamental and which is universal energy. Yeah, some people imagine about the energy come from universe. That's also correct. But you can also understand as a universal energy, which means that universal for everybody. Yeah, so all the living creatures have energy inside the body, and then you cannot live alone. Actually, you really need to receive and absorbing Reiki energy. So this is the energy, and then this is called in Japanese Reiki, means that you have this energy, like a life force circulating inside the body. We call this Reiki. Yeah, so distance Reiki is not much difference. Even you don't feel the people maybe is in the same place, but actually what happening to you is the same thing happening to you. So you are actually receiving energy in distance way. My experience about receiving distance Reiki, the sensation of receiving Reiki is slightly different. Because I cannot really feel like the same way. Like if people really face to me very close, so of course I can sense the people is really close to my body. But distance Reiki is slightly different sensation. But the surprising thing is you can really feel some energy flowing. So that's my sensation. Sometimes your body really getting warm, like I feel like your body temperature getting warmer. Sometimes you really feel relaxed and sleepy. And sometime after you receive Reiki, so you find it your emotion even more uplifted. Like this is really clearly known as if you have some depressed or some sad or worry, so that's those kind of negative emotion you experience. Then after you receive Reiki, so your emotions is really dramatically changing. So that's what I experienced in the past. I also got a chance to send in distance Reiki to many different people. So we do have these lots of different practice using the distance Reiki with my students. So sometimes I send to you, you send to me. So we have so many distance Reiki practice like this way. And sometimes if I have somebody, maybe I worry about one person, I worry about my friend, I worry about my family members, I immediately do distance Reiki to them. So this is really helpful. Actually, not just helping others, but I really want to say I really helping myself, because I could know after I try distance Reiki, my emotion, my physical level, so all the thing, all balance as well. So not just helping others, but I also help myself as well. So this concept is always the same. No matter you do Reiki on somebody face to face, or you do distance Reiki to somebody, but this theory is, the concept is always the same. So it's not really distance Reiki directly go to the person, but you connect Reiki, then you receive Reiki, and then the Reiki can send it from you to somebody. Yeah, so this is distance Reiki. So I hope you enjoy distance Reiki, especially because we are not going to sacrifice any energy. You also keep receiving and gaining energy at the same time. So I hope that you could feel the benefit of distance Reiki. And if you can get more chance to practice distance Reiki, will be very good. So I think then you also find that your emotion is more balanced, and then your day seems like really smooth. Yeah, so that is my personal experience of distance Reiki. Sometimes I also suggest people to do distance Reiki again and again, because I think what I can imagine, because people is actually, even we don't practice Reiki therapy, but we as a living creatures, we need energy all the time. But we also can waste the energy anytime. For example, I talk and then I record a video, I create a video. So this is also activity I'm wasting the energy now. But Reiki is something that I really can gain again. So this is like your energy going up to gain energy level. But sometimes you move body and then you have a lot of activities. Of course, you can have a chance to waste the energy. So sometimes you feel really stressful. That's also make your energy low, right? So I found it the practice Reiki is really giving you the chance to raise up the energy again. Yeah, so this is really simple and easy. So you can understand about Reiki is really, I hope that you can do as a daily basis. So this is really my part of my life now, like a practice Reiki or either distance Reiki or Reiki. So this is really a part of my life now. So I hope that if you have a chance to learn Reiki, Reiki is really helpful for your daily life. And then that is the tips to improve of your quality of the life. Sometimes I receive the question about distance Reiki from my students time to time. So I'd like to share the two questions today. So one question that is that possible to help somebody to reject your help. Yeah. So you can you imagine this situation? For example, maybe you have your friend facing some trouble, and you understand. So she or he having a trouble now. You want to help them, but cannot. Yeah, we have so many situations like that way. And then thinking about this person, you find it yourself is so helpless, and then you find it no power to help him or her. It's really bad situation. So. In that case, of course, I like to try my distance Reiki to the person. And then for my opinion, I like to say, yes, I would help by sending distance Reiki to that person. Yeah, I definitely do. There's some different opinion, like last time I heard about, oh, so the distance Reiki have to be done if you only receive the permission from the people. I think this is because the idea difference. Yeah, if you assume that Reiki is a treatment in a hospital, for example, you are receiving a treatment, and then you assume that this Reiki therapy is really change you everything by receiving energy, and then it seems that so we are talking about the therapists have a right to change you or something, like a change person's maybe physical, emotional, and mental level. So we cannot take responsibility about that. So, but in my opinion, actually what I want to say is I understand like this way. So distance Reiki or no matter Reiki or distance Reiki, because this energy is something that you always have, something that you always circulating in the body. So what happened to you when you receive Reiki? So you just simply gain your energy amount. For example, you have 50% energy in your energy bottle. So this is your body. And then you gain like 50%, but you are missing another 50%. So if you do the distance Reiki or Reiki, so you receive Reiki, you can gain the energy level. So that's happening. Actually, we are not doing any special treatment for the people, but just giving a chance to gain the energy. So that's what we can do as a Reiki practitioner. So this is not really special energy to make you changes, or sometimes like, oh, is that the magic that I have a lot of changes in my life? But this is not because the therapist do it for you, but actually you have your power, you have your own potentials. After you receive Reiki energy, you gain energy, then your potential, your healing ability improved. So that's why your body can perform better. So that's why some people have a miracle happenings after Reiki, for example. Yeah, sometimes I heard about the people after receive Reiki, wow, I changed a lot of things in my life. But that doesn't mean because therapists do Reiki for you. This is part of the thing we can say about that. But the main, more important thing is because you have that power, like you have that property. Yeah, because you have your body and you have a way to do. So we are only the part that assisting your energy flowing. And after you receive energy, so then you gain energy, then your ability to heal come back to you. Yeah, so we can imagine like this way. So for me, I don't really get permission about doing distance Reiki because of this reason. I also heard about Usui Mikao used to say that, like, when people suffer depression, so why not you can send distance Reiki secretly, like silently, so you can help person. So this is really perfect idea for me, like sometimes the people really depressed. I have experienced the situation. Actually, it's also my own experience as well, because I'm kind of a person, if people ask me like, oh, do you need help? And then I say, no thanks, I can do that. Yeah, I'm really stubborn, like sometimes people suggest that you maybe need my help, but I say, oh, no thanks. Yeah, but you know, the distance Reiki is so simple, and then I really like to promote more and more distance Reiki, because this is not really giving you another gift or special present, but you just, you know, to gain energy, that's all. So sometimes I also happen that some people saying the same phrase like me, and then they say they don't need my help. But after I secretly, silently do distance Reiki that person, I really could know that the person really sucking energy, that kind of a sensation, because I really could feel the energy is really direct go to the person. So But I don't really surprise because if this was me, then I can understand because even I tell you about, oh, I don't need help. But if somebody sending Reiki to me, then I have no doubt maybe I absorb a lot of energy and absorb a lot of Reiki from you. Yeah, so this is people. I understand like this way. But I really like the idea about sending distance Reiki. So if you are not sure about what is this and you have like a questioning about distance Reiki, then don't worry. But if you are just learn about level one or you never learn about Reiki, maybe this distance Reiki idea is quite new and you need to learn about technique. Yeah. I don't say if you didn't learn about this technique, you totally couldn't do it. Maybe some people were kind of, wow, I have done. But definitely better if you learn this technique in level two, so you are more reliable, like you are really more stable practitioner that you really can do distance Reiki with confidence. So I suggest you to take level two to learn about the whole things about how to do distance Reiki successfully. And another question is, how do you know that your Reiki successfully sent? Yeah, this is another big question that sometimes, so okay, so let's do distance Reiki. So you in a course and then you learn about how to do it. And then this is the practice time so you can send at the first time, but you don't know is that sent or not. I always tell students that if you have very relaxed, calm and a sleepier sensation, like after you connect Reiki, you practice Reiki, we always have a one or two or maybe three, that's kind of a relaxing, calm, peaceful sensation you are experiencing. So that's happened to you even you practice distance Reiki. So the one big important thing is so whether you have this sensation or not. If you still worry or you still question mark about am I sending distance Reiki or not, or after you started you still have like a really very awake and you are not really like a flowing with energy, that sensation, maybe you are still not that stable sending distance Reiki. But actually in level two, if you learn about symbols and mantras, so that's really help you a lot about sending distance Reiki successfully from you. So most of the cases is don't worry. And then Reiki does no harm. So even you didn't send successfully, you didn't send that successfully, but it doesn't really cause any harm to the people and to you. So don't worry. So I think in this case, you need to do more practice. Yeah. To be more confident about distance Reiki. Yeah, so today in this session, yeah, so I promise you, so we're going to do the free session of distance Reiki. So maybe I'm going to perform distance Reiki to you. So some people watching me video, so you can receive by watching my video. Or some people watching my video now, you can do distance Reiki. You can also practice on me as well, yeah. So you can imagine my body, then you're going to connect Reiki. So it's the same thing that you can try as I do, okay? So first of all, we're going to connect Reiki. Yeah, in different school, maybe you are taught by different ways of connecting to Reiki. But in my class, so I usually raise up the hands. Yeah, more you get used to it, maybe you don't have to raise up the hands. You can really connect it to Reiki very quickly by just this position. That would be okay. But sometimes you are not confident yet and you are not get used to it, then you can raise up the hands. Imagine that you are Reiki, the Reiki is nicely flowing into your body. Yeah, like a falling from the sky. So it's really comfortable and very simple, easy to imagine. The warmth and this nice well-balanced Reiki energy is falling and flow into the body, is touching your hands and touching your head. You can even imagine the Reiki energy go through your body, right? So from the head and from the hands, and then that's slowly going down. You can imagine your whole body is absorbing Reiki nicely now. You are going to tune well and receive more Reiki energy flow into your body. Yeah, so usually you can also feel maybe your hand sensation different, like you find it some warmth around the hands, or some people may experience some ticklish sensation on the hands. If you're closing the eyes now, you can also feel some brightness feeling, yeah, in your eyes, even you closing the eyes. If you couldn't feel any sensation at the moment, then you can also chant in the mind, I connect to Reiki. Yeah, so immediately I could feel my body is kind of wrapped up by warmth. So it's really comfortable, warm sensation around my body. Okay, so now you can put down the hands on the thigh. So this is how to connect Reiki. You can also do with your own way to connect Reiki, but I found myself connect to Reiki is really important practice at the beginning when you start Reiki. So now we're going to do distance Reiki. Yeah, we have so many ways to do distance Reiki. Today I'm going to use hands and imagine like so is here is the energy ball, yeah? And then I'm going to send distance Reiki from screen, like from here to there, you there. If you know about your distance symbol and other symbols, so you know how to use your symbols, mantra, so you're going to draw your symbols, like visualize your symbols, chant mantras in your mind. And then after that, so you're going to just wait. Yeah, after you did all the symbols, you don't really have to concentrate. Yeah, you just feel and enjoy this moment, like sensation through your body and hands. Yeah, sometimes I have seen students, they want to manage how the energy flowing, but in Reiki, we don't need that. Yeah, just let the Reiki energy flow. That's much easier and not difficult. But if you try to concentrate and put energy from to there, so that will be really tiring. Yeah, we don't do so in Reiki. Yeah, usually I start it like after we draw symbol, I draw symbols, mantras, then I feel really relaxed and sleepy. Like I want to close my eyes, but if I keep talking, usually I don't have to. But I could feel the difference. Yeah, it's definitely different. Like before, I'm not started yet distance Reiki. Now I started already with symbols and mantras. So I could feel the difference of sensation that's happening in my body and my hands. Yeah. Can you feel your distance Reiki now? Like if you are practicing Reiki, distance Reiki to me, do you have that sensation or not? Some people not really confident about symbols and mantras, then you can also draw again and chant mantra again. Yeah, it is really important, like once you receive your symbols mantra, so you receive attunement from your teacher and you learn what is symbols and mantras in your class, then just write correctly. Yeah, don't write something really mistaken one, or you don't remember, you just write randomly. So it's better you go back and then check again and then do it again and again. So if you are more used to it, maybe working more faster, yeah, and more stable. But at the first time, if you just learn Reiki symbols mantra, so I suggest you to practice enough. Yeah. We are also doing the Zoom online group Reiki session. It's really perfect, the session for you if you want to learn more and practice more about distance Reiki, because in that session, so I can see you face to face through the screen. It's not really face to face in person, but I can see you on Zoom, so we can practice the distance Reiki each other. Yeah, so this is really the Zoom online distance Reiki. Yeah, this is perfect idea for you. And then you could know about is your Reiki distance Reiki really sent or not. Yeah, it is really nice practice, so I really enjoy a lot, and then I hope my student also did too. Yeah. Yeah, what is your sensation now? Do you feel really good? Sometimes during receiving the distance Reiki, you have many different sensations. For example, some people feel a lot around the head or on the chest or go to the back or many different parts of the body. Some sensation that's rising from your body. For example, some warmth, ticklish sensation. I don't think many people experience pain, but usually that is something like warmth, ticklish, or sometimes the weight, like a heavy or lighter, that sensation, many different sensations through your body. That's actually happening, that Reiki knows how to flow nicely. So even I just send Reiki to you now, I'm not really controlling energy to you or that part of the body, but Reiki energy really knows that how to flow Reiki. Is because your body know how to flow nicely. Some part of the body maybe not enough energy flowing. Some part of the body is suffering some stagnation of energy. Then your body recognize that, want to improve that part, so the Reiki naturally flow to that part and solve that problem. We can understand that this way. Some people may experience the reactions after distance Reiki. So I always explain about reactions for those who receive Reiki therapy in my session, like in person, the people come to my studio and receive Reiki. So usually I also explain about the reactions. That also may happen in distance Reiki as well. So what is the reactions? Reaction is something like you have that stagnation of energy, for example, and then after your stagnation release, then some body condition also improving, but that's also like a process of your healing. So sometimes you are kind of a detoxing activity that's happening in your body. For example, you might have some toxin in the body, like physically, emotionally as well, like some emotion that's stuck in your body. Then you might experience that actually your body or emotion want to release it or want to get it out. So detoxing is like, some people want to go very often to the toilet, or some people sweat a lot and thirsty or very sleepy because you are overworked too much. Many different reactions, but the body have some reaction after Reiki is because your energy is promoted. Your energy flow promoted. So sometimes this is really different from, for example, if you are on the medication. So basically medication is really working on suppression of the symptoms, but the Reiki energy is a flowing, like really releasing and detoxing as well. So you can also be aware about reactions in some cases. But reaction is not really for all people. So this really depends on your body condition. Whether your body condition sometimes really need reactions for further improvement, your body believe to do so, then they will do that job. So that's reaction. So most of the time you just drink water and take rest. So please take enough rest. For example, you feel unwell, like after Reiki, you feel you're kind of a dizzy, you find it easy to get tired, so like a sleepy sensation too long. But I don't suggest you to work too hard, right? So better to find the time to take rest. You need to enough rest at the beginning, and drink more water. The water also help you to metabolism in your body, so that's also really helpful. But only two things, so this is really simple. If you have seen a doctor and with on the special medication, so I also suggest you can also go back and see doctor again in case you worry too much about the reactions. It's okay. But reaction is really natural reaction from the body, so that will be needed after your energy promoted to flow. So how do you feel? I feel quite relaxed and calm at the moment. It's really nice in my muscle, I can say. I don't feel many tension, and actually I have a pain on my left wrist in this morning. Maybe I don't know, I wearing a watch here and that is too tight for me. I find it, my wrist is painful, but now I'm doing this, I find it quite less pain at the moment. I don't know why. Usually I keep like this, I find it maybe become more painful, but I found it quite easy and very relaxed muscle I experience now. Okay, so now I'm going to finish distance Reiki to you. So I gassho. Thank you. So this is how I do distance Reiki every day. So basically I can do distance Reiki anywhere, I can tell that. Yeah, most of the time indoors, but sometimes or suddenly some people say, oh, can you send distance Reiki to me? Yes, no, why not? So I quickly going to do distance Reiki to you. Yeah, so this is my part of my daily life, and then this is my practice of distance Reiki. So I hope you enjoy this video today, and I hope you like more Reiki and distance Reiki. And if you'd like to more know more about Reiki or practice more Reiki with us, so why not? So you can also join our Zoom online session. So here in Hong Kong, if you live in the Asian region, so I'm here, Satoe is teaching Hong Kong, but now we do the online session. So I have two online sessions happening. The one for those, anybody can join. So if you are never learn Reiki, you never experience Reiki, or you want to learn Reiki but no receiver Chume yet, so join us 40 minutes Zoom Reiki session. So this is possible for you, and you experience a self-healing and distance Reiki receiving. Yeah, so that's 40 minute session. If you receive Reiki attunement before in the past, so you are also can come to our group practice Zoom session. Yeah, so I have a two session prepared, so you can also check in the comment below. And if you want to look more information in Canada or America, so please find Nasreen. The Nasreen doing the session in Canada, so we have time difference. So you can, I paste about her information as well in the comment section, so you can find us here. And I hope I can see you next time, face to face, but on Zoom. Or maybe you can come Hong Kong, and yeah, if you're living in Hong Kong, yes, why not? We can see each other as well. Okay, so thanks for watching, or see you next time on YouTube. Okay, so bye.